Hey, I'm Dylan John, and let's cut out the fluff and dive right into these 5 tips. Tip number 1, I find super helpful so my workspace doesn't feel so claustrophobic. Let's say you're editing and you extended your timeline to be large and your viewport and inspector window have been compressed because you really would like to just see everything on the timeline. Going into the inspector and then adjusting things, especially when you have lots of different effects on the clip, can be unbelievably difficult because of how compressed it is. Here's the trick though. All you have to do is double tap the top of the inspector window and it'll go full screen to the bottom so you have way more real estate to adjust settings. I mean, really, we're only ever editing on a specific section of the timeline, usually the middle, so it's not like extending this affects too much. Then you can just click it again to bring it back to that normal size. Tip number 2, I know is gonna help quite a few of you, I hope at least. Let me know if it does. Let's say you have this clip that's sandwiched between 2 transitions with media on top and sound effects attached below it, and you realize later that the clip doesn't really fit. You don't like it that much. You probably get annoyed at how you can't drag the clip out of the way to make way for another clip, and I see a lot of creators using gap clips on the primary storyline for this reason. But here is the solution. When you have the clip you'd like to replace the original with, just drag it over the clip and let go. This menu pops up and you have a few different options you can choose. Hit replace if you want the entire clip that you selected to take the original clip spot. Now the potential issue with this is that because the clips are probably not the same length, it's gonna extend or compress things. So if you don't want any shifting like that to happen, I'd suggest choosing replace from start or replace from end. What this does is it'll replace the original clip starting from the first frame or the last frame you've selected in your library so that everything stays in sync. If the clip is longer than the original, it'll cut off the excess. If it's shorter, it'll extend the media so it fits. And just a heads up that if you're selecting part of your clip towards the end and you try to replace from start, this window will pop up letting you know that there's not enough media to replace the original with. So in this instance, you'd have to use replace from end or be okay with everything compressing. I can hear some of you saying, yeah, but Dylan, what if I want to swap it for a clip that has already been added to the timeline and has effects on it and stuff? You can't replace the way you just mentioned. That is true. Here is my workaround. First things first, I'll move the transitions, and if you have nowhere to move them, what you can do is make cuts by pressing Command B, and then temporarily putting the transitions in those spots. Drag the clip you want to replace over the original, trim either the start or the end by pressing Option Left or Option Right bracket, and then hit Option, Command, and Down Arrow. This blasts that clip into the primary storyline, replacing the clip you had below it. Then I just drag over the transition snug into place, and because I can sometimes be a little OCD, I click the cut sections of my clip that I used to hold the transitions and press Delete. This mends the cuts in your clip. Let me pause real quick to tell you about a total gold mine of a service if you're creative. Today's sponsor, ENVATO Elements. Here is why a subscription with them is worth it. ENVATO Elements has 55 million assets that you can download. That is a number big enough to make your brain spin. It has Final Cut Pro and Motion 5 plugins, like tons of different transitions, really cool animated templates, titles, and more. You can create better sound design with their large list of sound effects as well as royalty-free music. Download their stock videos and photos for whatever your creative mind can come up with, and use their huge list of fonts and motion graphics for whatever you'd like. You can find everything on there, and I mean everything. The best part is you can download as much as you want, unlimited downloads on all of their creative assets, and what's cool is that they offer a 7-day free trial so you can see for yourself that it's worth it. Use the link in the description and you'll get 50% off when you select the annual subscription. Become a better creative and join the ENVATO Elements family. Chances are you've been annoyed at how when you're scrolling through your media in your library, there are all of these selected ranges still up on your clips. And when you select a clip, those ranges are automatically selected. It's a little frustrating. The solution to clear a single clip is to select it and press Option X. And if you really want to save time and clear every clip all at once, hit Command A to select all of your clips and press Option X. If these are way too many shortcuts to remember, I'll leave the link to my free Final Cut Pro cheat sheet that you can download in the description to help you out with these shortcuts and a lot more. If you've seen some of my other tutorials, you may remember that by holding the Grav key, this little orange icon will pop up and you can move about your clip freely, even if there's sound effects, other clips, and titles attached to it. It's basically one of the ways that you can cancel out the magnetic timeline if you'd like. However, it is pretty annoying that you have to hold the key while moving the clip to do this. Well, you don't. Hit the Grav key and then hit Command, and now your ability to override connections will be activated until you turn it off by hitting the grav key again. So you do not have to hold that key anymore when you want to perform that function. This is something that I learned from my good buddies Matthew O'Brien and Brad from Brad and Donna. And little bonus tip, kind of adding on to tip number two that we learned, you can drag that clip that you'd like to replace the original with next to the original, then click the original clip, hit the grav key, and press delete. Everything attached will stay in the same spot, and from here, you can trim the clip if you'd like. However, this only works if the clip is longer because you'd have to take off the transitions to extend out the shorter clip. You may or may not know that by pressing the J key while on your timeline will play in reverse. The K key will pause, and the L key will play your timeline forward. But by holding down the K key and then holding either the L or the J key, you can play back your timeline in slow motion. So you can possibly see how your transition looks, how your framing is. Whatever you'd like to see in slow motion, you have that option. You can also fast reverse or fast forward by pressing either J or L multiple times. And once again, using the K key to pause.
If you enjoyed this video, you will definitely enjoy my part one and part two videos of things you're doing wrong in Final Cut Pro, so check those out when you get the chance, and have a fantastic rest of your day.